Sophie Chan, and I'm back with another manga review, and this manga is Imadoka? Oh, already failed. I feel the fail, and it burns my throat. So this starts, as you saw, this starts off with our main character, who her first name is not great. So I'm just gonna call her by her last name, which is Tenpopo. Or Tenpopo. Tenpopo. Which apparently in Japan is also a flower. Which is really kind of fun and crucial to the plot. So she is from Hokkaido. And she's basically going to move to Tokyo to go to a better school. And like her parents saved up and decided, you know, whatever high school you want to go to, sweetheart, go for it. We're all for that kind of thing. So her first day going there is just to see her school and stuff like that. And she sees a guy planting tenpopos, which happens to be her name and the flower. Ah! And she thinks that's really cool. And so her first official day, she goes into school, accidentally sees the same guy. When I mean accident, I truthfully do, because she kind of runs into him. And it's like, hey, you planted those tenpopos, right? That's really cool and sweet. And he's like, I don't even know you. And walks off, which, yes, they only met yesterday, said some stuff about flowers, didn't say any more, but you could at least be nice about it. So they find out that, well, we all find out in the book that this is a really prestigious school, and if you're shelling out the cash, this is basically where you're going, and your parents are rich, and just have enough money to be like, just do whatever in school, kind of. And you find out that Tenpopo's family basically saved up enough money for her to go, and that's the reason why she's there. And so everyone treats her like a commoner and doesn't treat her very nicely, which is kind of sad because in real school, like, nobody gives one. Which is funny. So, Tenpopo just kind of drives through it. She doesn't care. She wants to go to school. And she's basically finding out that there's a gardening club. And joins it. Which she finds out that the guy who was planting it, which is like Kazuyoka? Oh, goodness. What is... Oh, God. You, yeah. Kuguyu? Kukua? I'm blistering the name. So, it's the guy who goes into... planting. You plant stuff. So that guy basically is like, he doesn't like people, he doesn't like interacting with people, and so he's in the gardening club to garden just to kind of get away from people. And when he finds out that this girl's joined, he's like, oh, why me? Which, never do that, kids. Just be happy when people join your club. Cereal. So Tenpopo gets used to that and is gardening and stuff when she runs into another person who's, like, really a tech dude, and tends to play, he doesn't play pranks, but I know he's really into tech, and he really kind of likes Tenpopo, just never tells it to her, but he's one of those people that he just didn't want to. He kind of joins the gardening club just to kind of get out of that. And because Pope was there, you know, yay. Then you find another girl who's kind of picking on Tenpopo, and Tenpopo, it goes over her head like, seaweed. I guess it's the best relevance to anime. And you find out, because Tenpopo's like, you don't look so good. She runs to the restroom, finds out that that character is pregnant. Which I'm like, I don't think Japanese people would get that pregnant that easily. Only because I keep hearing trouble about Bouncing and Wow-Wowing. Because guys and girls have husbandos and waifus that are anime. So, I'm sorry. I would lovingly move and help you with repopulating if I was Japanese. But that's okay. So she basically is pregnant, and that's kind of a big thing because her dad is a crime boss, and that's the reason she got into there. And the guy that she liked, that now she has the baby from, doesn't give a rat's butt. Sounds like America. Anyway, said nothing. So what happens then is that Tinpopo becomes friends with her. She also comes to the gardening club. Everyone kind of starts to bond, and of course, the first guy that Tinpopo finds, she basically kind of falls for. And it's kind of a relationship, but kind of not really. And as the story goes on, which it's five volumes, yeah, I got that. That the girl gives birth to a baby, everyone supports her. Her dad's just like, I'm happy that you're at least okay. The guy kinda is there, but he's really transparent, even with the baby. Like, so it's a very, very interesting manga, and it is very sweet. It is a slice of life, and yeah, it does have like bits and pieces of drama, and it is kind of goofy. But it's by my favorite author, which is Yu Watase. Love those. Just love the manga. Love the style. It is a really awesome read. So if you have read some stuff by Yu Watase, this is another one straight out of the park. I would recommend. And I guess because of some of the subjects, I'll go 18 and over for at least personal reasons. But guys or girls, I really would recommend this if you feel you should want to read it. So if you like this video, definitely leave a like. Also, I've been seeing my dislikes go up. Hey, if you don't like a video, do as you please. It's America. And comment down below if you have a favorite character from either this manga or from Yu Watase's work, or if you've read this. Either or, I love that. Mine, I think, has to be the tech guy because he's so goofy and realizes that kind of what he's doing is the D word. Just D moves all over people, and he realizes that he could do better. So, kind of the improvement aspect that's really kind of cool. He is my favorite character, though. And so, if you would like to subscribe or subscribe out to me, definitely do that because I upload videos every day from Sunday to Saturday, Monday to Sunday. Whenever you want your videos, I upload for you. And if you want to follow me on Twitter or Instagram, sorry, it took me a minute. I think allergies or whatever's kicking into my nose that makes me transparent. Thinking. So, if you want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook, the links are down below. I hope that you are having a wonderful day and a beginning of summer, I believe. So, anybody who's getting out of school for summer, or I know in other countries they have either a week of summer or so like that, I hope that you are having a great summer vacation, and I hope it's not too warm where you're at. I hope. I know it can get really crunchy sometimes, so. We'll figure it out. Bye, guys.